Welcome back, Pez Collectors. I got this box of Pez in the mail last week, and I don't know how I waited this long to open it. Because this is something, there's two things in here that I've been wanting for quite some time now, and I finally, I hope, found ones in good condition. So let's open these up and take a closer look. And they are both full body Pez, like you probably noticed in the description in my thumbnail. But let's open them up and take a closer look here. Hopefully these are in as good condition as the pictures looked. I find it really hard to buy vintage Pez online because you can't easily tell if the head is floppy or if the spring is loose or if there's any cracks or, you know, weird paint issues with it. So you have to ask a lot of questions, which if you're buying Pez online, especially vintage ones, then, you know, make sure you ask all the questions that you need to know before you buy them. And I did buy these from John Laspina, so he said if I don't like them, or I guess if they're not up to my standards of what I think they look like from the pictures, that I can send them back, which I really appreciate that. So hopefully these aren't going back. Oh my gosh, can't wait to look at these. Start with this one here. And another cool thing is that these are both from Marianne Kennedy's Pez collection. And John's been selling off her collection for, it seems like months now, I don't know, on Facebook. So if you want any of these really cool Pez dispensers that he's been selling, you might want to check out that Facebook group. I'll link it down below in the description in case you do. Not, you know, sponsor or anything. I just like buying from John. I always trust his opinion when I buy vintage Pez, and I know I'm gonna get something good. I mean, there are other sellers out there that you can trust to buy vintage Pez, but I like buying from John. Or the other alternative is just to go to eBay and, you know, hope that you get something good, which I've bought a lot of vintage Pez on eBay, and sometimes they come in good and sometimes not so good. Be real careful with this one. Aw, this is so nice. I've been looking for one of these for quite some time, and I've never bought one because usually the paint on them are really chipped up. Oh my gosh, the head is so tight. And the sleeve, this is like super, super nice. Well, let me show this to you. I don't want to keep it all to myself. Check this out. It's a full body Santa Claus. And one of the reasons I really wanted this is because last Christmas Pez released the full body Santa ornament. And ever since then, I was like, I gotta get one of those for my collection. I think that really kind of sparked the idea of buying one of these. So that's one of the reasons I wanted to buy this. And plus, I've been trying to get all the Santa Pez dispensers, and I think I might have them all now. Like Santa A, B, and then C. There's a whole bunch of them, but this was one of them, one of the vintage ones I didn't have. And I don't think I've made a video show my Santas yet. So look forward to that when it gets nearer to Christmas, because I do have those in my office. I don't keep those down on my Pez display because I really do like them. And I have quite a few different variations of like Santa A's and Santa B's, which I think are really neat. It's so much lighter and smaller in person. I don't think I've ever held one of these. I've seen them at, you know, Pez conventions. I've seen many pictures of them online, but to actually have one and hold one here in my hands, this is so nice. Now I'm looking here on the boots and it says made in Austria. That means that this is the more easier one to find, I guess. I did pay $125 for this, which is still a lot for, you know, like a vintage Pez, but I think that's one that most people probably can afford if you're looking for, you know, a vintage Pez that's gonna be actually worth something, I think, down the road. It's not just a super common, you know, no foot vintage Pez. And it's something a little bit more unique. Like if you have this in your Pez collection, people, you know, come look at it, they're gonna be like, oh, what is that? Like, it's pretty, it doesn't just look like a normal Pez dispenser with a stem. Now there also is one of these that says made in Germany on it. And those usually go for maybe about $100 more or so than this made in Austria one. So that's something I guess you can look for if you like variations, but I don't know if I'll ever get two of them. I think I'm happy just having one. Sometimes I like variations and sometimes I don't. I'm not sure if there's any other differences between those two, but if there are, then I think that might be a reason to get them. But otherwise, if it's just like the stamp or the, you know, little marking on the back of them, then I probably would just have just this one. Now, if you think this is cool, then wait till I show you the other full body Pez that I have here. Wait, don't look at this. I'm gonna fast forward and I'll show you what's in here. It's a full body space trooper. You might hear people call them robots or full body spacemen, I call them sometimes. But this is a blue one. This is so cool. I love this. I love space stuff. I love sci-fi stuff. So to add this to my collection, it's so nice. So I believe that this is a light blue space trooper. In John Laspina's book here, it does say that there is a blue, a light blue, a medium blue, a navy blue, a gold plastic, gold plated, red medium, red dark, and a yellow. So there's all those colors that you can get, and I'm figuring that this is a light blue because in John Laspina's price guide, he has light blue listed as $325 to $350, and I paid $360 for this, and my price guide is a couple years old. So I'm just going off of what I have here. So I believe this is light blue, so if you know, or maybe I can look more into this after I shoot this video here, but I don't know, I love this. I didn't have any of these space troopers in my collection. So I think this is only gonna spark me wanting more. I know some of them get even more pricey because in the price guide here, like I said, gold plastic, and it says estimate around $8,000 to $10,000. And then there's also gold plated, which is $4,000 to $5,000. So that's pretty crazy. And then there's a blue no made in Austria on robot. So I guess there's no made in Austria imprint on it, and that one goes for $1,000 to $1,500. So on the back here, right below the like the little Pez pack, I don't know, the little pack that the space robot wears on its back, it says made in Austria. So it's like right here. So that's the indicator that it's just the basic normal Pez space trooper. But if you find one without the little imprint on here, it's gonna be worth, you know, $1,000 to $1,500, maybe a little bit more. So that's pretty cool. That's a fun little thing I guess you can look for if you do have these in your collection. If you want to find some different variations, you can, you know, pick out colored variations. You can pick out, you know, if it has the made in Austria here on the back, which I think that makes it even more fun. It also says that there's space trooper that's thinner, and there's a yellow one, and it says it's estimated between $8,000 to $10,000. I don't know who has that in their collection, but that would be really cool to see. And then there's also, it says Space Trooper Thin Pez on sleeve, and it says gold plated, and that one says $8,000 to $10,000 as well. So I guess there's a thinner one, and then there's this regular style. So there's a thin gold plated and a regular gold plated one, and those are two, I guess, if you find those, you know, out shopping at a flea market or, you know, estate sale or something, you better buy those. Someone must have those, because otherwise we wouldn't know that, you know, that they even exist. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. And check out the inside of this. I should show you the inside of the Santa too. So the head is blue, the space trooper is blue, and it does have like glue going down each side. And I asked John Laspina, you know, about that. He said it's just typical for these space troopers to have that. And I also asked John Devlin, I sent all over the pictures to him. Not that I don't trust John Laspina, but I just wanted another opinion because, you know, I was paying $360 for this, which is a lot of money. So I just wanted to make sure that, you know, what I was buying was actually going to be good. And plus, since I got these from Marianne Kennedy's collection, you know, they're going to be probably really nice, you know, pieces anyway. But I just want another opinion because there's not a lot of information out there about these Pez space troopers. And I'm sure there might be some like stuff in books or something, I don't know, but just like going on the internet, I couldn't really find anything about them. So I was just like, hey, you know, what's your opinion on like the glue that goes around it and, you know, like the condition of these based on the pictures. So I had two really good Pez experts, you know, look at this for me before I bought it. And I really appreciate that, all the help that, you know, I get from other Pez collectors when I buy stuff, especially John and John. But check this out. I don't want to pull it up too, just want to be easy on it. But check it out, it has a blue stem on the inside and the head is blue. It's so nice. This is in really nice condition. Like, I mean, for how old it is, it looks like in really nice condition. And the Santa, it doesn't really have like the glue oozing out like the space trooper, but it does have like a seam going down the sides. And a lot of times you'll see like the boots like scuffed up, or the red paint around the body and the hat scuffed up, but this one actually looks pretty good. Sometimes people have repainted these, so you have to watch out, but I don't really know how to tell if they have been, but this one actually looks like really nice. Like it has a little bit of like, I guess like a scratch or I don't know what you call it, like a wear, like where it's worn thin, you can see the plastic underneath it. But otherwise, like the top display part, it looks really good. And even if it was painted, I don't know if I'd be able to tell. So this looks really nice. It's gonna look really great. I think displayed on my Pez shelf. These are so great. I really wanted some full body Pez after getting that Santa last Christmas, the ornament one. And they stand up really nice. I just wanted to show you the inside sleeve of the Santa. It's just like the same like off-white color as the rest of the Santa color, like the plastic. And then the little Pez pusher here is red. The head's so tight and the spring works really nice. This one also has the little red candy pusher down in there as well. And I do want to mention that the Space Trooper one, it's a blue plastic. It's not painted like the Santa one is. Maybe the fact that there is no paint on this one, it makes it look so much nicer. And then plus they can't hide the glue with the paint. Maybe that's why you see the glue. These are so nice. I love these so much. Well, since I'm showing you the two full body Pez that Pez made, and these were released back in 1955, which is a really long time ago. But prior to 1955, Pez was selling pretty well in Europe, and it was marketed for people to stop smoking. But once they were doing so well in Europe, they decided to come over to the United States and start selling them. But people back in the 1950s in the United States didn't really care, I guess, to stop smoking. So Pez over in the United States didn't sell really well. So Pez went back to the drawing board and they came up with these full body Pez. And instead of marketing them to adults that want to stop smoking, they decided that they wanted to market them to kids as a toy and a candy dispenser. These didn't go over really well though because they were so expensive to make. I mean, look at all the plastic that it takes to make them. And I guess it probably takes more time to assemble these. So Pez had to go back to the drawing board again. And that was in 1957. So that's how we got our first Pez dispensers of the kind that we know nowadays. You know, just a basic Pez dispenser with the head and the stem. So you can see how much less plastic there is to make these Pez dispensers with the stem versus the full body. So since 1957, that's when they started making the Pez on the stems, which are the ones that they still sell nowadays. If you go to the store, if you go to Pez.com, you can buy a Pez with the stem. So I think that's really interesting. And I do have one more fun fact about these full body Pez. Before they started making these, like I said, Pez was marketing the Pez dispensers as a anti-smoking, I guess, product, and there were really weird Pez flavors. There was lemon, which isn't too bad. Then there's peppermint, which I guess this kind of seems like a gum or an Altoid or, you know, mint that we might eat nowadays. But the weirdest flavor to me is a chlorophyll mint. And I actually went to Google and I looked up chlorophyll mint, and you can actually still buy products nowadays that are chlorophyll mint, and it's supposed to be like healthy. I don't know anything about it, so don't take my word for it. So then once Pez started making these full body Pez and marketing them towards kids, that's when we got the fun fruity flavors. So we got like orange and cherry and grape. And I think even lime was a flavor, but lime's not a flavor we have anymore, which sounds kind of like a fun flavor because I like lime, like sparkling waters a lot. So lime Pez might be actually really fun to have. So now I think I need to go back and buy some regular Pez dispensers that were made prior to 1955. So I can fill in my gaps and like start from the beginning and have a couple, you know, regular Pez, and then have the full bodies. And then the next one after this is the Witch Pez dispenser that was released. So I think I need to buy a Witch Pez and just keep filling in my collection from the beginning. I think that'd be a lot of fun. At least a fun way, I think, to add to my vintage collection. Cause I think I need more vintage Pez. So what do you think about these full body Pez? Do you like these as much as like a regular Pez with a stem? I think these are so cool. I do have a couple other, like the regular Pez spacemen or like the astronaut ones. And then I also have, like I said, a bunch of the Santa Clauses. So to add these to my collection, I need to go organize them and put them in like their own little areas. Or maybe I should make a full body section. I don't know, but these are so nice. And I'm really happy that I was able to add these to my Pez collection. That's it for this video. If you want to learn more about Pez collecting, you might want to hit that subscribe button. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up. If you think other Pez collectors might enjoy this video, you know, feel free to share any of my Pez videos with them. I think they would like it and I would appreciate it as well. And if you want to help support the channel, I did set up a Buy Me a Coffee, which I changed it to Buy Me a Pez Dispenser. So if you want to buy me a Pez Dispenser, I'll put the link down below here in the description. and you can check it out there and buy me a pest dispenser if you want to help support the channel. And I think the best way to support my channel is just by watching my videos. I really appreciate all the Pez viewers that I get, and I love talking to you as well. So, you know, go follow me on social media. I'm Erin Collects Pez over on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. I love hearing from you. Whenever I get comments or, you know, messages on those platforms, I'm always like, oh yeah, this is so cool. I love talking to other Pez collectors, especially because I meet so many new ones that aren't just like in the Facebook groups. There's so many more Pez collectors out there. So I really love talking to you guys. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you Thursday. Bye. I write to you in poetry with words left on the shelf. Full of dust, you'll know it's me and from nowhere.